This is the Amazon package that the router technologies EX2080 Extreme Extension Professional Router Bit / Colette Extension come in. So let's just open it up. This is what it look like. It said that made in the USA, but different to some of the photos that I have seen. The label on this is almost unreadable, and it looks like that it's just some painting rather than the inscribed into it. On some of the photos that I have seen, it has the extreme extension on this, and down here it has some very nice writing. The photo that I have seen are too small to see what the writing is. This I get from Amazon Australia, so hopefully this is a genuine article. I pay including the $6 or $6 delivery come up to about $88. Two other Australian companies sold this, and one go for about $100 plus delivery, and the other one is $145 plus delivery. I don't know why the price difference. So coming from Amazon Australia, I hope that it is a genuine article. Before getting this, I check out some others, and although they have positive reviews, I don't know where they are made. So I choose this because it has some very nice review, and this is made in the USA. I have seen the one from Tokala and CMT, but both of them are unavailable. So the next best option is this one. This will take in the half-inch router bit, and this sleeve here will take in the quarter inch. So this is almost a 2-in-1 extension. So this is one of the reasons why I picked this as well. This is the mechanism that used to tighten and loosen the bit. So we just keep turning this, and it push this one forward until the barrel become a perfect circle where we can insert a 1.5-inch shank bit in. So like that, so it just go all the way in, and then we have to tighten this. So it's more than I don't know how many turns that is. So until that we feel that it is secure. Oops, not yet. Yeah, it's a bit, it's not a scrub screw, that for sure. So as we keep doing, turning it in, tighten it, there's a gap that keep pulling the bit into place. Yeah, so now it's secure now. Let's just loosen it. Yeah, so that's just a tiny bit more than a quarter turn. Now, and then we can put it out. So just to, and then now we put it back in. And then we just push this one up a little, and then tighten it. And it is a secure. So the fact that we put this one in, it's almost like there's a gap in there, something that's sticking out from inside of this, and it's holding the bit in place. On some other review, people mentioned that. So we pulled it out, and it's sort of making a pop sound like that because the air being sucking out. I don't know if that's true or not. I don't know much about this, but that's what they say. And this hole there on the side, it doesn't have anything in it. So other people mentioned that this is just a counterbalance to this and this, just to make it spin evenly. That's what they said. I don't know if that's true either. Now, this is the sleeve that come with it. It's supposed to hold the 1.4 shank, But I haven't been able to get this lip to work with my 1.25 inch sunk bit yet. However, if I'm using the standard collet that come with the router, I can actually tighten it and using it. Yeah, so that it is there. So I can just put this one in and tighten this, and it will secure it in place. So yeah, I'm not sure what the story with this is. It look okay. So, but that's okay. For so long that I can use this, and I'm happy. Now let's talk about the dimension. It said here, extend your bits by 1.25 inch. So I got that before I actually ordered this. I work it out. So that worked out to be around 33 mil. So that's okay. But the diameter of this is a little bit of a mystery to me before this. One of the major selling point of this is we can actually change the bit above the table. And so we just keep winding the table up until this one come up the hole. And we just unscrew this and change the bit that I have done. I was under the impression that the diameter of this is about 44. I don't know how I come to that. But no, it's only 34 and a half or something, not 44. So even before I order this, I accept the fact that I won't be able to change it above the table. I will just have to get down and then unscrew this and put in the router bit and screw it back in. It turned out that this can pass through my hole, which is about 34 or something. But because my hole is not perfectly centered, so it get a tiny bit of it get caught toward the bike. So that's not a major problem. That's my fault, not this one's fault. I ended up enlarging the hole at the bike so that I can change it above the blade, which worked out quite well. So I'm fairly happy with it. One of the issues that I have gathered with this from all the reviews that I have read on Amazon Australia and Amazon USA is the vertical clearance. They may not have the vertical space to use this collet. So what other people end up doing is they put the spacer between the blade and the router. Luckily for mine, when I lower the router at the maximum level, I got about 83 mil. And the overall length of this is exactly 62, I may say before. Before I ordered this, I knew that I have enough vertical clearance for it. So that's something that we should keep in mind when considering this. It states that this collet is not to be used with handheld router on non-variable speed. The maximum speed recommended for this collet is 24,000 RPM. My router has 6 speed and the maximum speed is only 22,000 RPM. And I have never gone to that. I have only used it at about 20,000 RPM. So I'm quite safe there. So let's see how it's run. I secure it onto the router. And presently it's set at 20,000 RPM. And I haven't actually put in any bit yet. According to some of the FAQ that I have seen on the manufacturer website, they say that when we put this one on, the router can make a different sound. I haven't run it yet, so let's just see how this one go. so far just by ear. I just couldn't tell that it made different sound. And people also mentioned that it tend to be wobble a little. But I don't worry too much about that at the moment. The positive review are more, the percentage of the positive review are more than the negative review, much more than negative reviews. So I will pretend to have confidence in it at this stage and see how I go with real usage. Let's do some tests using this piece of scrap wood, but very flat. This is an upcut of something I planned out before. Also on a 12, one and a half inch straight bit that I have been using. Yeah, it feels the same to me. It feels the same as when I was using it without a collet. But then again, I haven't been using it much, so that may not mean anything. I'm guessing that with time, I'll find out. In regard to the long drought a bit, we may not be able to use it with this collet. Because even if we lower the router down to the lowest level, the bit still sticking up too much. This is my 3.25 inch straight bit, around 82 mil in total length, and the shank is around 40 mil. And the depth of this collet is only about 27 or something. So when we put it down like that, it's just sticking up too much. So this is something that we should keep in mind. We may not be able to use it. So we may just have to take the collet out and put the router bit in. So yeah, that's just the way it is. Thank you for watching this video, and thank you for staying with me all the way to this point. Thank you very much and take care.